everybody. Today I'm in Las Vegas. I want to do a video tour for you guys. This is Las Vegas Main Strip. It's located on Las Vegas Boulevard, which is about 4.2 miles long. As you can see on the video, this is a nighttime video. The temperature right now is around 73 degrees, which is a little bit cooler, and it's October, so it's definitely much cooler than in the summertime. During the week, the most busiest time is Friday and Saturday. That's when you'll see the most amount of tourists and people here. Now, I would recommend you guys, if you're coming here for the first time, I would recommend getting comfortable shoes, since you are going to be walking long distance of about about 4.2 miles long. So I would recommend wearing comfortable shoes. Also, if you're coming here during the summertime, June, July, August, I would also recommend get a sunblock. It's gonna be pretty hot out here. On the right side, this is a restaurant called Gilia's Saloon Dance Hall and Barbecue. It's a very popular place. I see a lot of people inside eating. There's TVs inside that you can watch, shows, news, sports, great selection of food, burgers, barbecue, salads, drinks, you name it, this place has it. I would definitely recommend this place if you go in there the first time. Another restaurant that I would recommend, other than Gilia's, is Senor Frog's. This place also has a great selection of food, has great burgers, Mexican food, has all kinds of drinks, alcoholic drinks, regular drinks, you name it. That place also has great reviews, just like Gilia's. You can't go wrong with either of those two choices. I would highly recommend those two if you're going there for the first time. If you're looking for something high-end, and if you don't mind spending a few dollars more, I would recommend Gordon Ramsay's restaurant, Hell's Kitchen. You might have heard of him. He has quite a few TV shows, so that's one of his restaurants. This two-story bus in front is a very good way of moving from place to place around here. If you don't have a car and you need to get from one place to another, this two-story bus on the left side is very useful going from one place to another. I believe it's $8 for a full day, so it's not that expensive. Looks like it's a good crowd today. We see a lot of tourists today. Even though it's October, we still see a lot of visitors who come to visit this place. As you can see, it's very popular. Even in October, there's a lot of people visiting this place. One thing you will notice when you come out of here is you have people selling stuff, like you just saw right there. You will see people selling some drinks, some souvenirs, some gifts, gadgets, balloons, any kind of toys, anything they can sell. You'll find a lot of people selling, trying to offer you things to buy. That right there, you see like a lava, like fire. It's in front of a hotel. It's one of the things that sometimes hotel resorts, they trying to provide some entertainment and a great way to get customers in the door. So as you walk around, you will see a lot of the different entertainment shows. I would like to take this opportunity and ask you guys, if you like this content, can you please subscribe, like, and comment? It will definitely help out. Here we see more people selling things. Even though I'm doing this video and I'm walking during the evening time, at night time, as you can see on this video, it's so bright out here. So many lights everywhere, everything is lit. Everything is shining, colors, brightness. It's very enjoyable walking around here, even in the evening time, because everything is so bright. You can see still everything, and it's just a great atmosphere. I do wanted to give you guys a heads up also, if you're coming here for the first time, that a lot of resorts like Anna's that you see on the left side and other resorts, hotels, they have a lot of them have shows going on. So if you're coming out, depending on the time of the month, time of the year, I would recommend checking out certain hotels, resorts, and to see what kind of shows they have. Sometimes you see shows like comedy shows, dancing shows, circus Soleil shows. So they have a variety of shows depending on the month and the year. Another thing that you will see when you're out here is you will see showgirls dressed up, and if you would like to take pictures, you can take pictures with them, and of course they're gonna ask you to pay for it. They have not just showgirls, but they have other folks who's dressed up like in Mickey Mouse that you see, cartoon characters, you can take pictures with them. Here again we see a character who's looking for someone to take a picture with him and make some money. Speaking of dangerous things, here's some dangerous stuff, holding snakes. Yeah, this is interesting. Yeah, I don't know if I want to do this. It's a little bit too dangerous for me, but that's another thing you can do, hold some snakes. Good crowd today, having fun. It's a beautiful evening time, great weather. Couldn't ask for a better day to walk around here and be here. So yeah, it's a definitely an awesome day. If you look on the left side, you see trucks, cars having signs on them. This is a well-known, it's a common thing here in Vegas, where you'll, as you walk, you'll see a lot of cars driving by, and they have marketing signs, some kind of someone's promoting a show, someone's trying to advertise something. So it's definitely a common thing here in Vegas. Here you see a hotel with a beautiful sculptured statue with a beautiful waterfall fountain. It's a great place to take pictures, and we see in front of us a lot of people are taking pictures, photos. Maybe you want to visit nightclub. The one on the right side, Omnia, is a very popular nightclub here in Vegas. It is located in Caesar Palace. Right there you see in front of you. It's a popular nightclub right here. There's so many cars on the road over here in Vegas, so much traffic, and that's why even earlier on I recommended using a bus, two-story bus that they have. Also, you can try Lyft, Uber if you would like, but yeah, it could be pretty harsh here on the roads. In front of us, it's a Hell's Kitchen restaurant that I mentioned earlier. This is Gordon Ramsay's restaurant. If you're looking for something high-end, if you don't mind spending a few dollars more, you're looking for something unique, yeah, Hell's Kitchen is a good choice. There's a couple that looks like getting married, taking pictures with this beautiful fountain. This fountain is located right next to Hell's Kitchen. It's a nice little spot where you can take some pictures photos. Most of the hotels and resorts here in Vegas, they have casinos that you can play, and not just casinos, they have other options like shopping. You could there's restaurants that you could visit, so it's not just a regular hotels out here. There's so much you can do inside of a hotel, inside of a resort, like casinos, shopping, restaurants. So they give you a lot of options out here. I'm standing in front of a Bellagio hotel. Bellagio hotel is one of the nicest hotels around here. I gotta tell you guys that this water show is pretty amazing. I remember coming here for the first time, and I saw this, I was like really amazed at how well, how beautiful. It's a great spectacle to see for sure. If you're planning to come here for the first time, I would definitely recommend putting this in your bucket list, putting it on your to-do list. You don't want to miss this show right here. It's in front of Bellagio, and usually they do it every 30 minutes. The music is playing, the water is moving and from side to side, up and down, and just creating this great view for everybody to see. So you definitely don't want to miss this. And of course you're gonna see this in the video right in front of you right now.
Okay.
The water show just finished, and people moving along now. As you walk around, you'll notice sometimes you'll see performance from either a group of people, maybe a dance show, a trick show, magic show, people trying to make some extra cash. Again, in front of us, we see a showgirls inviting people to take pictures with them. Again, if this is your first time coming, don't be surprised if you take a pictures with some showgirls and they ask you to pay over $100. So just FYI, be prepared to pay for those pictures. Here we see some more showgirls. We see people selling certain items, certain things. Looks like some kind of balloons, decorative balloons. Quite often you'll see people trying to sell drinks. Seems like every quarter of a mile there's somebody selling drinks. You see it right there in front of you guys. There's some drinks right there someone's selling. Looks like a good crowd gathered today. Good amount of tourists. Good amount of folks gathered today. The one thing that I did wanted to add also, you guys, is there's not that many places, but there's one place in particular that I've seen here on the main strip is where you can watch a live band, music band perform. You can grab something to eat and just sit there and listen to music band performing live. There's not that many, maximum probably two places here on the main strip, but I definitely seen one for sure. Because of so many cars, so many traffic around here, as you see in front of you, they created this bridge instead of a sidewalk, a normal sidewalk. They built this bridge that you can just cross the street that way, and it's much easier. I think it works out pretty well actually, with so many people walking, so many cars on the streets. This makes it a little bit easier and comfortable going across the street this way. It's definitely works pretty well for everybody, it looks like. Yeah, as you can see, it's a great view over here from this bridge that you're crossing. as you cross this bridge, you will see quite a few restaurants, shopping places. You can come down this escalator, or you can go ahead and enter one of the stores. There's another bridge to cross the street over there again, as you can see. So there's multiple bridges to cross the streets. Here we are walking on the second bridge now, crossing another street. There goes the two-story bus. There goes the cars with advertisements, as you can see. With over 4 miles of walking, you definitely get a good exercise for sure. Here you see a car with an advertisement on top of it. There's some shopping centers. Across the street you see more hotels. We're about to pass some of the interesting shopping areas. Here's a very interesting and unique bar in front. Looks like a candy store right here. If you have a sweet tooth, here's a place for you. A lot of candy. Get some more people in uniforms, costumes, trying to take pictures. Here's another great, great bar. It's called Breeze. Breeze Bar. Across the street, there's more hotels. There's a roller coaster also right there. I don't know if you can see, but across the street, there's a roller coaster. Right there, right in front of you, across the street. There in front, you could see a Statue of Liberty. Of course, seeing that kind of makes you feel like you're in New York, but it's definitely a smaller version of a Statue of Liberty than the one in New York. There you see a closer look at the roller coaster right there. Some nice looking palm trees right in the middle of the road. There's Hershey's chocolate across the street on a wall, as you can see, an advertisement looks like. Here's another advertisement on the cars passing by. I gotta tell you guys, looking at the Statue of Liberty does give you that feeling like you're in New York. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed watching it, and I hope to see you guys on the next video. Thanks.